This video is sponsored by PokeTownStore.com, the place for all your Pokemon TCG online needs. The new Sword and Shield online booster packs are also available, so definitely check them out, PokeTownStore.com. Also, if you use the coupon code ZapdosTCG, you get 5% of your next order. How amazing is that? Check it out. What's up YouTube, it's ZapdosTCG here and welcome back to another TCG Jack Profile video on my channel. In this video, we have on the menu Mewtwo and Mew Tag Team Jax. In combination with a lot of Psychic type attackers, this is going to be the new way we're going to be playing Mewtwo and Mew Tag Team Jax. Of course, Malamar is also part of the deck and in this video we're actually going to explain which kind of attackers you can use in this list and why it is so successful. This is a kind of a list that is very popular in Japan right now, so we do expect that it is going to be very popular in the West as well, and it has crazy matchups across the board because we can put the opponent to a low card hand, and that's through the attack of Night's Watch in combination with the new powerful supporter Marnie. Marnie puts the opponent to a 4-card hand, and then with Night's Watch they are left with 2 random cards in their hand. Hopefully that is enough to win ourselves some games. So let's explain this deck while we go through it. Also, I just want to apologize for my voice, guys. I'm a little bit sick, but I want to get this video out as quickly as possible so you guys can start testing with the updated Mew Mew list. Okay, 3 copies of Mew Mew is going to be the case. We don't need more. The reasoning for that is that we do have Cherish Ball, we do have Quick Ball, the new and improved search for basic Pokemon, and we also have Mysterious Treasure. So finding Mewtwo is not a hassle. We also run Air Balloon, or actually the new tool card that reduces the retreat cost by 2. So getting out of the active position is easy. So only 3 copies is the way we play Mew Mew. And Miraculous Duo GX will be live more than ever before because we only run Psychic Energies in this list. You could go for a Aurora Energy and try and some different attackers, like for instance the Greninja, so you can have an answer against Obstagoon. But typically if you use Mew Mew and get the Night's Watch attack off by copying Trevenant and Dusknoir's attack, you'll actually put the opponent to a low hand size, and what are the chances that they get a Rare Candy and an Obstagoon in a 2-card hand, right? So 3 copies of Mew Mew. Moving forward, we're going to be running 2 copies of the Dusknoir Trevenant. This card seems to get more and more popular by every new set that gets released, and this is going to be fantastic with Night's Watch. Not only is it nice, you can use Pale Moon GX if the opponent has a low hand size. That means if you if it stays in the active position, they automatically get knocked out. That's a neat GX move. You have a lot of GX moves to use in this particular list, but Night's Watch is the attack we're going to try and spam. We get the energies thanks to Malamar and the Psychic Transfer, actually a recharge ability. Get the energies onto Mew Mew or on a Dusknoir Trevenant, and out of nowhere, after using Marnie, the opponent will be left with only 2 cards in the hand. Moving forward, we are going to be running a nifty line of Malamar. There's going to be 3 Malamars in here, and then 2 Inkay and a Ditto. Why the Ditto? I'll explain that after I'm going to talk about Naginadel, but first off, Malamar is fantastic. We've seen it before with the Giratina, and this time around, Malamar is going to charge up our Mew Mew or a Dusknoir Trevenant, which is fantastic. It could also charge up Latios and some other attackers, which you're going to see in this video. But it's fantastic to get energies back from the discard pile. We're only going to be running 9 Psychic type energies, so we are going to have enough to last us through the game thanks to Malamar. And 2 copies of Inkay and 1 copy of the Ditto. These are now easy to find thanks to the Quick Ball. The Quick Ball will make sure that we can find Inkay, but also Ditto Prism Star, and the treasure will find Inkay. So getting Inkays is going to be fantastic, easy than ever before, thanks to the many search cards. All right. Now we're going to talk about some Pokemon that we also want to run in this list. We're going to be running Latios GX. Not only is it nice to use Tag Purge if the opponent is a heavy Tag Team GX deck, for instance, a Greens build with Reshizard, for instance. If they only run tag teams, then Latios can use Tag Purge to just slow the opponent down. Also nice if they also run Mew Mew in the mirror match. It's gonna be fantastic to try this attack out. And also, we have Clear Vision to make sure that the opponent cannot use their GX move. In this scenario, you can stop them from using Alter Creation GX, for instance, in a Zacian V ADP list, and also against other heavy focused GX deck. So Clear Vision, don't underestimate this attack. Next up, we're gonna have the Gengar and Mimikyu. This is stronger than ever before to donk people. Why is it in here? This is gonna be the first time that in Sword and Shield that the player going first cannot use any supporters. Let's say they only have 1 Pokemon in play and they attach and pass. Well, then you immediately get out your Gengar and Mimikyu and use Horror House GX. That means on the next turn, The opponent cannot play any cards down. That means if they are still stuck with only one basic, we can donk them. So that's why it's in here. And Poltergeist is also fantastic. They're gonna be with a huge card hand after you just, the opponent can only smack down on energy and pass. If they only have one Pokemon, Gengar Mimikyu will win games, mark my words. But also for two energies, you can smack a huge amount of damage thanks to the amount of trainer cards the opponent will have in their hand. So Gengar Mimikyu. The other attacker here is Naginadel. This is an attacker you definitely need if you're up against Obstagoon, because you can evolve your little Ditto all the way into a Naginadel GX, and then you can use Venom Shot to make quick work of those Obstagoons that try to use Obstruct to just stall the entire game around. So also it's nice to snipe off the Dedenne. The Dedenne does have 160 HP. Naginadel can easily snipe that Pokemon and get ourselves two prize cards. This is going to be the way you also close off games. Or maybe use Night's Watch. They retreat to the bench. They don't have a lot of HP left. Bang. Naginadel is your boy to just take prize cards. Next up is going to be Dragonite GX. We're using this for the Sky Judgment. 270. You can smack that. That's enough to just get rid of Reshizard. You can destroy Mew Mews, even if they have weakness, guard energy, or whatever. 270 is just a nice number to one-hit KO almost any relevant Pokemon in the game. Also, don't forget, the Big Charm is now part of the metagame. So even if a deck like, let's say, Pikaram tries to use Big Charm, 270 is still enough to get through a Pikaram with a Big Charm. So there's also Dragonite in here, so a lot of one-offs you can use. You can only use these attacks if it's in the discard pile. For instance, Dragonite has to be in the discard pile in order to use it. All the rest you can get manually out. Naginadel you can evolve thanks to getting Ditto out. Gengar you can also smack manually down, but it's going to be the best way to put him in the discard pile because we don't have a lot of bench space. Then, the Megalopunny and Jigglypuff, this is going to be used in mirror matches. Let's say an opponent uses a lot of Mew Mews. You can punish them by using Jumping Balloon, smacking a lot of damage. 60 damage plus 60 more for every GX they have out. Also works out fantastically against Pikaram. And also if the people play a lot of Dedenne down, this will help out a ton. So don't sleep on this attack. Not only that, you also have Puffy Smashers GX sniping 200 if you have 5 energies in total. Okay, lots of attackers as you can see. Now to some support Pokemon, we're going to be running two copies of Dedenne. Dedenne is fantastic, definitely in a format where going first, you are not able to play a supporter down, then you can use Dedenne. You can find it with Quick Ball, you can find it with Cherish Ball, and you can get yourself rolling. You want some Incase early down, early phase of the game, so using Dedenne and finding yourself some Quick Balls and Mysterious Treasures to make sure you have two NKs down is going to be better than ever before. Also saves you if they reset stamp you or Marnie, so very fantastic card in this list. And also the downside of throwing away your hand is not even too bad here, because we can reuse all these GXs, their attacks, if they are in the discard pile with Mew Mew. Okay, next up, one copy of the Absol. Absol will help us out with the Dark Ambition. That means if you're up against a deck that relies on Jirachi and Stellar Wish, you make sure that they cannot retreat with their escape board, that Jirachi needs an energy in order to retreat. So Absol, very great in today's metagame with Sword and Shield. Okay, now to the supporters. Four copies of the new and improved supporter. We're not gonna be relying on lots of Cynthia's in today's meta this time around. It's Professor's Research, throw away your hand and draw 7 cards. Very straightforward, and that's very good in this list. Not only do you get psychic energies in your discard pile, you also get your attackers in the discard pile. It's just way too good in this list. You can use Dedenne and use Professor's Research to dig even deeper into your deck to find that crucial card you're looking for. Okay, now four copies of Marnie. As mentioned, people will now grab to Marnie instead of like Cynthia, because you can put the opponent to a low hand size, which will win games. In this particular deck, it helps out in combination with Night's Watch. You can use Marnie, put them to a 4-card hand, use the attack Night's Watch, and hopefully they will brick afterwards so you can go through all of the opponents that try to stop you. So very straightforward, 4 Marnie, 4 Professor's Research. It's kind of like very similar like 4N for Sycamore back in the day, so there's that. Alright, moving forward, 4 copies of the Quick Ball. Also discard effects, so you discard maybe an energy, which is good to get back with Malamar, find yourself a basic Pokemon. So straightforward, it's nice because a lot of these Pokemon are basics, and this also grabs yourself the Dedenne GX, if you are bricking. Then, 4 copies of the Mysterious Treasure, very straightforward, finding Psychic-type Pokemon, there's a lot of them in there, Gengar, Mimikyu, Latios, Inkay, Malamar, So this is gonna be the main way you can find those psychic types. So lots of search cards in combination with good supporters make sure that this deck is consistent as hell. 2 Cherish Ball. Sometimes you want to find just the GX without having to discard effect. Well, there's the Cherish Ball. 2 copies. Next, 4 copies of Switch. Why 4 copies and no escape boards and all that? Well, these switches will help to get, of course, your attacker back in the bench position so you can recharge it with Psychic Recharge. This is nice to just re-get energies back from a Venom Shot, for instance, but also helps out to just get out of nasty situations. Sometimes people use Pale Moon GX in the mirror match, get out of there as fast as you can. And also, with Absol in the format, a lot of these basic Pokemon do have more retreat than they seem, so 4 copies of Switch is the way to go. There we have him. Next up, 2 copies of the Air Balloon. This is a new tool card, making sure that the retreat cost of your Pokemon is reduced by 2. If you get an Air Balloon onto a Malamar, the Malamars have free retreat. So insane. If you get it to a Mew Mew, it also has free retreat. Instead of just relying on like things like a skateboard and stuff, this is better. Air Balloon, we're not running a Jirachi package, so Air Balloon is very good in this list. If you want to even have free retreat all the time, you might want to cut like a switch for a Dawnwing's Necrozma, but be careful because Dawnwing's Necrozma might be a liability in the late game, only having 180 HP. So, moving forward to Energy Spinner. Why is this important? Well, on the first turn, we cannot play down any supporters. Finding energies will be crucial to put them in the discard pile or to just have that manual attach of the turn if you go first, so 2 copies of Energy Spinner will be a must. You can maybe use Quick Ball, get the Dedenne, and maybe find one of these cards to find energies. And if you go second, you can even get 3 energies, which in total works out if you can then play a supporter, then you can get a lot of them in the discard pile. 2 copies of Energy Spinner, very popular card in the new meta. Next up, 2 copies of the Big Charm. This helps out a ton with the HP and the numbers. If you can get this to a Mew Mew, they have 300 HP. Not a lot of people smack 300, definitely considering the fact that on the first turn you cannot use a supporter, so even things like Reshizard will not get their welder off 2 times in a row if they go first, so we do have a little bit of time on their hand, and if we use Nice Watch and Marty, the chance of them having energy and welder is a little bit slim, so Big Charm helps out in those cases because we have more HP, which means we survive a little bit longer than we might. 1 copy of the Great Catcher, still a perfect way to close off games, get that Dedenne, just knock it out, easy as pie, or just get yourself the KO on a Pokemon that is already damaged, for instance an ADP that gives 3 prize cards up, or maybe something else. You only are able to catch her down GXs, but it is what it is. Reset Stamp, okay, this is fantastic. In the late game, stamp them down to 1 or 2 cards and then use Nice Watch, and out of nowhere they don't have anything in the hand, so it's a must in this list. Next up, 2 copies of the Chaotic Swell. This is a broken card considering the fact that Power Plant is the only way you can shut down a Mew Mew. So if we make sure that we smack this down, the Power Plant will not get in play in the first place. Also, it is nice to make sure that Lysander Labs does not ruin our numbers with the Big Charm, and also, other stadium cards like Thunder Mountain. So if you smack down Chaotic Swell on the first turn, Pikachu players might have it hard if they don't find their Marshadow. Maybe it's prized. It can happen. So Chaotic Swell, stopping Power Plant, stopping other stadium cards. And then, simple to close off this deck profile, 9 basic psychic type energies. This is the new art, by the way, for the new energies from Sword and Shield. Looks pretty nice here with the stamp. Crazy effect. So 9 psychic energies will last us through the game. As mentioned, we do have Malamar to get them all back, so don't worry about discarding them with the Dedenne or the Professor's Research. So this is the deck profile video for today of the Mew Mew, the updated psychic type variant. It does have a great conversion rate in the Japanese tournament world, so it is a very great deck. Try it out for yourself. Let me know what you would change about this list, and if you enjoyed the video, be sure to mouse the like button. Sorry for my voice, guys. Hopefully it'll be back in a couple of days so I can get yourself some more excitement throughout the video, but hopefully you enjoyed this video nevertheless. Anyhow, have a fantastic rest of your day. Subscribe for more deck profile videos of Sword and Shield, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.